Hi, I'm Patrick, and this particular video is from the Ask Patrick series. Question that is asked is by Karishma. The basic question is, how do I pick up easy sets in the exam for logic? If I'm talking of logic sets, what is the way or means of trying to pick up an easy set? So understand that the most important part in the examination is the ability to pick up easy sets and solve. Specifically in DIR, if you end up picking up a tough set, you are going to waste a lot of time on it and maybe you will not even get an answer to it. So therefore, the ability to pick up easy set becomes very important as far as CAT is concerned. So there are many parameters which you can look at while trying to solve, pick up a set. So I will look at four parameters which are there. The first, when I look at a question, I will look at the length of the question. If it is too lengthy, okay, there is a high chance that I will take a long time just to understand what is asked or just to put the data in place. So that means a long and lengthy question should be ideally be avoided in the first round. Maybe you can come in the second round and check it out. But first round, avoid lengthy questions. The more the length of question, more the time to comprehend and more the time maybe to end up solving and getting the answer. So avoid lengthy questions as far as possible. Second thing that you can look at the variables in the question. If there are too many variables or too many conditions given to you, like you have people and you have color and you have position and you have the cars, you have four or five variables to you, it becomes more complicated. Lesser the variables, easier to solve. So look at the number of variables in a question. You will over a period of time identify how many variables is convenient for you to solve and how many variables is too much for you to solve as and when you practice. So variables is the second condition you should look for. Third, look at the questions. If the questions are quite lengthy or the questions has an if statement, that means there are a lot of conditions given to questions. For every question, you will have to end up solving again. Again, that is no as such. So question forms also good, important part of your decision making. Lengthy questions and if questions should be avoided as far as possible. That makes the question most time consuming to solve. Because every question has to be resolved. Third, which is to be avoided as far as possible. And fourth is the familiarity. If you are familiar with the question, you know how to basically solve it, you can pick it up. If you're not familiar with the questions completely new, then maybe you can come back to it later. So I put four variables as of now to pick up a set. One is the length of the question, right? Second is the number of variables, third is the questions, and fourth is the familiarity. You can add your own variables to take a decision. So over a period of time, when you practice, you should know that these are type of questions which are tough and these are which are easy. Try to figure it out and it should help. Decision making process and therefore cracking the sets. Thank you.